Hi, Jed.
Hi, mate.
Pal.
I'm putting a little package together for the homeless. I do it when I can afford it a couple of times a month. So I've got cheese and ham sandwiches there, Calypso drink, crisps, and chocolate. And I go out on the streets, in the doorways, and deliver it to the people.
How have you done?
Well, I did 10 packs. Let me tell you how hard it is.
Yeah.
So I've got bread. Butter. Cheese. It was like a conveyor belt. Cheese. So I've packed them all together. We're going to go out on the streets and get it rolling.
Fantastic.
Oh, by the way, don't worry about him. He's been here all day. He's not even helped me. Bit of a dummy. So that's what I'm doing, mate.
God, that must take me bloody ages to do all this.
Well, you can come along if you want.
Yeah, I'd love to.
Yeah?
Yeah, totally.
Nice one, mate. Alright, I'll just pack this together.
Yeah.
Do you want to take those crisps?
Yeah, will do.
Brilliant. Yeah, like I said, I've got about 12. And the doorways we're going to, they're going to be where people are really desperate.
Yeah.
They look desperate, they're on the last feed. So hopefully, all this, just give them that little bit of energy, maybe to go to the soup vans later. And you know, like I say, it cost me about 12 quid to do. I can only afford it to do it once every like 6 weeks.
Yeah.
But you know, someone's son and daughter in that doorway, isn't it, mate?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's get off to the street.
Let's go again. Yeah.
Whoops. There we go.
Let's do it.
Come on, man. Your name? Cheese and ham. Not for late, you know. I've got loads. Yeah, how long have you been here?
I've just come up, I've stepped in.
Yeah. How long have you been homeless? Yeah. Tough, innit? It's all about money, innit? Anyway, you take care, mate. Nice to see you and enjoy the food, yeah? See you now. Parcel, sandwiches and that. What's your name?
Darren.
Darren, nice one, that's top music.
Right.
How long you been in Bournemouth, mate?
Too long. About three years.
Yeah.
All in all, it's been like 15 years on and off.
What's the worst thing about it?
Like the people just walk past you. Don't let on until you're there.
Yeah.
No, I mean, I'm playing music too.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm not the best of players, but, you know, what does it take to stop, like, yourself speaking, I don't want people spending money all the time, you know, I mean, a bit of food now and then, yeah, that's great. And just to stop and say hello. No, that's all it takes.
Have you wrote any of your own music?
No.
Can you play us a tune now?
Yeah. Play Amazing Grace.
Oh, brilliant, first, Amazing Grace.
The first tune I ever learned.
Yeah. top, mate. Thank you for entertaining me. You have a top day, yeah?
Yeah, thank you.
See you again, mate.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, cheese. Cheese and ham, chocolate biscuit, a drink. All right, mate. Were you sketching then? Was you sketching? Drawing?
Yeah.
Can I have a look? It's good to see a street artist.
Not too good. The weather is not helping me.
Yeah. Whoa. Checker, Reno. That's amazing, isn't it? It's like Dali or something like that. Whoa, just get a shot of that. Emergency. Oh, please. Oh, man. That's Jesus. What's going on here, then?
What's happening in Nepal?
Yeah, the disaster in Nepal.
Yeah, I'm drawing this for a mask for the people. Help this.
That's brilliant. It's a work of art, that. I like that. What's your name again?
Jamie.
Pleasure to meet you, mate. How long have you been on the street?
Me? In England?
Yeah.
Ten years.
Wow. Keep on drawing, pal, because that's really good. Yeah, all the best,
I'm
brother.
I'm trying to take the people like you and them around me. It's very important. Yeah. Because I'm trying to resolve the problems, my passport.
Yeah.
And the people, you don't resolve nothing, so you don't believe I'm Jamie.
Right.
If you want people for confirmation.
It's all paperwork, isn't it?
I can't believe.
You take it easy, mate.
Oh.
Have a good day. You're a good man.
I'm trying.
You're an artist. Proper artist.
See you, mate. People like you. Like you.
Cheers, mate.
Yeah. I see what you're doing, it's a really nice thing. Who do you work for?
I don't work for anyone, mate, I just do it off my own back.
Oh, you're the open poet?
Yeah.
Respect to you, mate, how are you? Nice to see you.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you what, if you're touched by it, why don't you go out and deliver some sandwiches?
I wish I could, mate, I'm too busy, I've got to do the office, fix the computer, do accountancy.
That's what they all say, pal.
Well, I'll tell you what, mate, how many food or one box have you got left?
Well, I've got three.
Well, I'll buy them off and then it's £10.
No, you keep your money, mate. I'll tell you what I'll do. You're going to deliver them on the street, back to work. I'll give you three of my sacks. Okay. Yeah, I've got loads of lunch set in there. Yeah. You keep your cash.
Right, I'll deliver these and on the way back I'll drop £10 in the charity box for the homeless.
Oh, nice. Where are you from as well, by the way? I meant to ask you.
Me?
What country?
I'm born in Angola.
Angola? Wow.
And I'm created Portugal. And South America.
Brilliant. That is cool. Right, mate.
Can I give you one message for my son?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Yes, go.
You know, tomorrow is my birthday.
Happy birthday, mate.
Happy birthday to you.
Give your son a message.
Just I want to say, if I don't see you again, everything more important in my life is you and your mom. I don't know what can I do. It's not my country, but I have beautiful people around me. And Jesus all the time is telling me what my place.
Right.
I love you, my son, Thiago.
We've got food parcel here, some sandwiches, a few drinks.
Thank you.
You're welcome. What's your name, mate?
Jockey.
Oh, I'm pleased to meet you, Jockey.
Pleased to meet you. You're a poet, aren't you?
Yeah. That's an unusual name, Jockey.
Yeah, well, I used to be a jockey. What happened was, I was in a race.
You was what?
In a race.
You was in a race?
Yeah. I was going over the jump.
Yeah.
And this horse fell. Felt on me, broke both legs.
Broke both legs? Oh, man. So what happened then?
Well, after that, I had to give up my job. So I lost my wife, lost my kids, lost my house. I had to drink, and that's how I got here.
Man. look, someone like you, who's raced horses, maybe one day you'll be coaching kids how to ride horses and that. So it's never too late, mate.
Too late, that, mate.
Too late?
Too late.
Why?
Big sick.
Oh, man, you've got cancer. Well, I'm sorry to hear that, mate. Tell you what, look, I'll leave you because you're looking a bit tired, all right? So, see you again, eh?
Don't forget me, will you? Jockey.
I won't forget you, jockey.
Yeah.
Take it easy, man, yeah? See you
Thank
now.
Thank you.
Hi, mate, how's it going?
All right, mate, yeah.
If you wouldn't take me, Chris. What's your name?
Michael.
All right, mate. Some food there for you, bro. How long have you been homeless?
On and off. I've died here, haven't I? I've had flats, nothing, you know, drink, women, stuff.
What's the hardest thing about it? Being homeless?
Being homeless? Getting stick off the dough, stopping your money and shit.
Yeah.
You know? So they turn up for medical problems, stop your money.
Rely on what you can get by on.
Yeah, basically, yeah.
What's the flower about? I love that.
Oh, friend, Polish girl, tricky's put up in the end.
What a Polish girl does?
Yeah, she sells flowers going up and down, so.
It's just like your little garden, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's cool. Alright, bro, I'll leave you in peace. No, take it easy, thanks very much, yeah?
That's alright, mate.
See you, mate.
No worries.
Thank you very much.
All right, have a good day.
You too.
Be lucky.
How's it going?
Too bad.
Yeah, some food for you. Sandwiches, chocolate, a drink, Calypso, there's some water. And there's some Chris, yeah? What's your name?
Seamus.
Seamus, Irish name?
Oh, yes.
Where are you from?
Dublin.
How long have you been over here?
46 years.
Yeah. Are you, so you're living on the streets?
Yeah. I've been for the last 6 months or so.
What's the toughest thing about it?
Just survive day to day.
Yeah. Went to the worst part. Yeah. Did it nearly kill you? Yeah. Well, you're a brave man, mate. Yeah. How did you lose the leg?
Cancer,
yeah.
Yeah.
You're still here, mate. God bless you anyway.
Thank you.
Leave you in peace, man. See you soon. Thanks a lot. Cheers, mate. Chris, guys, about 10 packets of Chris there.
You know what? Thank you, mate.
You're welcome, bro. How's it going on here?
Going all right.
Yeah. Nice little camp, innit?
It's a nice little
camp,
yeah.
Well, you know what I mean?
Okay.
If you've got your bros with you and everything.
Yeah.
How's it been anyway? Is it tough to you?
Well, I ended up getting in somewhere, and that place wasn't for me. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
I ended up getting myself kicked out of there.
So what would you like, just a flat, a one-bedroom flat or something?
Flat for myself.
Anyone listening to you about it?
No one at all.
No.
Any the other week.
Have you got a little personal message for Mr. Cameron?
Oh, Mr. Cameron?
This is going on YouTube, so, you know,
Cameron,
you're...
You don't want him in power.
Yes.
You don't like him. You hate him.
Yeah. So, he obviously, he's not helping you guys
no,
in any way.
He's helping the rich, suffering for the poor.
Yeah.
He needs help, so I can catch him help.
Nice one, bro. What's your name, Alan?
Michael.
Michael. God bless you, our kid.
Are you going to show that to Mr. Cameron?
That's going on YouTube. Oh, I'm
posting. I won't even call him Mr. Cameron.
No, no.
I'll call him wannabe president. I've never been Borat.
So there, Mr. Cameron, you're loved, aren't you?
You're a gimp.
Eh?
You're a gimp. and I'm not.
Hey lads, that rocks.
Nice.
Have a good one. See you. Yeah. Thanks very much.
I hope you sniff coke off the dealer another day.
What do you feel about people living in doorways?
What do you mean how I feel about it personally?
Yeah.
It's really sad. What do you mean how I feel? What do you mean? Like, I don't understand the question.
Well, we're doing a little film about homelessness and highlighting the people that, in the worst cases, are living and dying in doorways. Do you know anyone homeless yourself?
I don't actually, no.
No.
I live in London, so.
Yeah. Have you ever. Are you afraid of the homeless?
No.
No. Yeah. What do you think the government could do about it?
I don't know where you'd start.
Yeah.
I mean, I know there's a couple of guys around me where I live in London that I talk to regularly, and their kind of situation seems to be stemmed from a mental health issue.
So what do you think are some of the causes like of being homeless in a doorway? What do you think brought people to that?
No support, no family support, lack of understanding about mental health. That's only my experience though. Two guys I know have had very bad mental health issues.
Yeah, thanks very much anyway for your time and that. Thank you.
Thanks.
Just I'm doing a few questions, you know, about homelessness and your view of the report. What do you think of people living in doorways?
I don't know. I've got no comment on it.
You know, comment on it at all?
No comment at all.
Do you know any reasons you think why they end up there?
I've got no comment on it.
Do you do a lot of cleaning up?
Yeah, I do. I've got no comment on that.
All right, fine. Okay. Have a good day, mate. Doing a little film project, asking questions about homelessness.
Okay.
Have you got time?
Yeah, sure.
What do you think about people living in doorways today?
Oh, gosh, that's a loaded question. It's one of those ones that's really hard to answer because it's horrific to see people that are on the streets and that don't have anywhere to go. But it's a case of I'm not quite sure what we can do to help.
Have you ever been homeless yourself?
No, I've never been homeless.
And what sort? Why do you think someone would end up in a doorway? What issues do you think they might have?
All different reasons. I mean, things with, like, the government at the moment, they've been cutting everyone's benefits, they've been putting on bedroom taxes, they've been kicking people out of council houses. You know, the past 5 years, I think there's been more homeless people through them, more than anything. But even all of them, you know, people have their own personal problems, don't they?
Do you know any homeless people?
No, I don't, unfortunately.
What would you do if you lost your job and everything went and you ended up homeless?
Gosh, I don't know what I'd do. It's something that I can't physically imagine, but I can, you know, I can understand how hard and horrible it is for people who are in that situation.
Would you be willing to hand out sandwiches now and again to the homeless?
Yeah, that's a great suggestion. The things we can do to try and help.
Yeah, well, thank you very much. That's been nice of you to stop and speak. Have a good day.
Okay,
thank you.
Thanks.
What do you think about the homeless camp being there? Are you guys...
I'm not from there, so...
Do you think it's... No. Do you know why they're there? Because they're homeless.
Yeah.
Have you ever been homeless or...
No.
You know anyone?
No.
No. Yeah. Do you think... What would you... If you were... Let's say you were the Prime Minister. She started. One lesson. What would you do to help the homeless?
Bloody help them out.
Thank you very much, sweetheart. And you go and get your dinner. Don't want you angry. See you later. Excuse me, mate. Sorry to interrupt you, but what do you think of these camps being here?
I don't know much about them. It's the first time I've seen it.
Well, the homeless people got issues and they can't get accommodation. And so they've set up here. There's a little bit of process saying they just want to live somewhere. And they've been evicted from the streets, so they're here and just thought, well, what your opinion is about them?
I don't know much about it. I don't know why they're here. There must be some sort of illness charity that can look after them.
Well, Well, all the cutbacks are kicking in, and charities haven't got the money they used to have. And this is their kind of protest. I just thought I'd get your opinion anyway, so thanks very much.
I'm sure there must be a way around it, because they can't really stay here, can they? They understand it's a protest, and they do need looking after, but...
Could a few of them come and live at your house?
I don't think so.
Never mind, mate. Thank you very much for your time. What do you think about the homeless camp there?
What about it?
Do you think it should stay?
Why not?
Yeah. Well, this is what I'm asking, you see, because they haven't got any accommodation to go to.
I don't know. I haven't said it to them, so. Have I?
No.
Have I? I'm all in favour.
Have you ever dropped any sandwich in or help see what they want?
I haven't, no.
No. They might appreciate that, you know.
Well, I'm a pensioner, aren't I?
Oh, yeah. Thanks anyway, mate, for your time.
My club. My club.
About the homelessness. So, what do you think about them living in those tents there? See, they haven't got anywhere to live at the moment. They've been evicted from certain parts of the street, and this is their next bit where they might have a week or two to go. So, obviously, someone's sons and daughters. Have you ever thought about this tent before, this camp before?
It's a shame that I feel sorry that they have to resort to camping here and everyone goes and just walks past them. But I don't really know.
Have you ever been homeless yourself?
No.
Do you know any homeless people?
I've helped out on soup kitchen.
Brilliant. And how did you find that?
Humbling.
Yeah. So you did your little bit to help in that?
Yeah, and I understand that I could become homeless, anyone can become homeless, the situation is going to change.
What do you think the government should do about it?
I think it's not enough affordable accommodation for people. But the thing is that once you are homeless, it's how do you get to then being able to dress right for an interview, and then get yourself back on the street, get yourself back
earning money and stuff like that.
But I think the government needs to provide accommodation for people that's affordable and not going to get them into more debt or into more trouble.
Well, thank you very much for that. It's a pleasure.
Thank you
now. Bye.
I'm so alone, I'm so alone, like an island in the water, no message after the tone. I'm so alone, I'm so alone.
Final race. Now he's in a better place. How many doorways have been a bed for the homeless people now found dead? Somewhere else another one dies as the cutbacks continue from the politicians' lies. God bless you, jockey. We could have done more. Maybe your death will bring help to the poor.
My heart's locked down. My heart's locked down. I just leave it, then retrieve it when there's nobody else around. My heart's locked down. My heart's locked down. There's a fuse there.